even in swing. So very nice and happy. So to make it, so may I request everybody, it will be take your seats, and for those of you who are participating in the parade, please be at. So I will call out the as a about 2 years ago at the Global City, then President-elect Madelyn Yu invited and announced that the next global summit would be in Morocco. The round of applause and approval and excitement, the audience at that time approved the Morocco event as well as this event that we're having today. So with that, not knowing that 6 months later, Boracay was dead. The beautiful beaches, the nice, the high tourist industry, Boracay, the Aquino, was actually diagnosed with an advanced form of metastatic cancer. It was then announced that it was then going to close to traffic, and then after that, it was. Boracay was in trouble, and it was closed. For 6 months, it went. Chemotherapy administered by the president of the Philippines for chemotherapy. And here we are, we excited. Here we are, welcome to the 2020 Global Summit. And to start off, we have the Parade of Nations. We have the USA, Philippine Nurses Association Foundation. Yeah.
the U.S. We almost weren't able to come, as you heard Pete Calixto say, Naya was close. When Taal erupted, some of us were already circling up in the air, and some of our delegates were stranded in so many countries. But finally, on January 15, I believe, Naya opened, so here we are. So we have representatives from all over. PNA New England, PNA New York, PNA New Jersey, Maryland, Virginia, Washington DC, Carolinas, California, for braving the elements and not canceling your flights, because we were told it's dangerous, it's still erupting, please don't come now. So we're all here and we reached the maximum capacity. Now, we have 15 students among us who are scholars. These are the excellent students that were rigorously selected by PNAA chapters and members to attend this convention. Where are you students? From around the globe. So 2020 being the year of the nurse and the year of the midwife, who leads caring for the planet? Nurses, right? As you saw, we all represent many countries in the world. It is our duty to make sure the planet is livable for the rest of the future generations, correct? So PNAA and our co-conveners are happy to present this summit to make sure that they take care of this planet, and we will make a difference. We will advocate for our planet. Thank you very much for being here.
Dr. Lacanaria is the president of the East of Philippine Colleges of Nursing. Dr. Lacanaria.
Erlinda Palaganas. Dr. Palaganas is the president of the Philippine Nurses Association Incorporated. Castor.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Name of Gundi Gatchuanin. Greetings from where I come from Baguio City. Thank you for, of course, I'd like to thank the PNAA for inviting the Philippine Nurses Association Incorporated to collaborate with, with, of course, ADPC and the CFO. PNA turns 100 in 2022, and we have many milestones as well as setbacks too. We look forward to our contribution to the Global Forum on Climate Change. We have been your partner also the last time that you were here. We embrace the challenges that climate change has been impacting on us as individuals, as families, as communities, and as a country, and of course, as the entire planet. As we claim that nurses are a voice to lead, we are one with you and all other local, regional, and international organizations in actively supporting policies to address environmental concerns such as climate change, carbon footprints, and the like. This conference is indeed very timely. Some of you, if not all of you, who came from all over the world have been affected by the wrath of the Taal volcano eruption. After almost 5 decades of slumber, Taal woke up. Was it a natural phenomenon? Was it affected by other factors? Climate change included? These are questions that might have to be explored. December 24, Bisperas ng Pasko, our country folks in Visayas areas did not have any Noche Buena, as Typhoon Ursula was in their means. And prior to that, Typhoon Kisoy in the Bicol area, one after the other. Mitigating factors, climate change, again, issues to answer. We recognize that our concerns are your concerns as well, and vice versa. We definitely are connected. Rising global warming have already become, and I quote from the WHO when they said that the 21st century's single greatest disruptor of economic, political, social, and biological stability. Just look at how the economic disruption has happened in Batangas. Last Sunday, we had volunteers who are here with us today who went to Batangas. We deployed 22 nurses for a medical mission, and all of them are quite happy to be back to report whatever and share with you later on. We will do our share in making our world a healthy and resilient home, because we are all citizens of our earth. Welcome to Boracay. May we be responsible tourists and live nothing but memories and dreams. Let us be responsible citizens of our earth. A great conference ahead of us. Magandang umaga.
From the Commission of Filipinos Overseas, and we will not be here without the Commission of Filipinos Overseas supporting us with our information technology and all of the influences that they have. So this morning, we have actually representing Secretary and Commissioner Francisco Acosta, Undersecretary and Executive Director Altavez Pimentel Naik.
Dear guests, distinguished participants and presidents, chapter presidents of PNA, to the third Global Summit of Filipinos, Filipino Nurses, good morning to all of you and welcome to Madelyn and to Boracay. It is with great pleasure that I welcome all of you here on behalf of the Commission on Filipinos Overseas. And please allow me to convey Secretary Francisco Acosta's warm greetings to all of you. Secretary Acosta would like, really want to be with you in this occasion, but was unable to do so in view of an equally important commitment. We are honored to co-organize this global summit with the Philippine Nurses Association of America Incorporated, the Philippine Nurses Association Incorporated, and the Association of Deans of Philippine Colleges of Nurses Incorporated. We are elated to see and meet many of you who have traveled thousands of miles to join this very noteworthy gathering of healthcare workers and celebrate the Filipino nurses diaspora. Next slide, please. Latest estimates show that about 10 million Filipinos either permanently reside or temporarily work in more than 160 countries in the world. This number tells us that almost one in every 10 Filipinos could be found somewhere outside the country as a teacher, doctor, nurse, engineer, musician, or working in some other occupation. In every corner of the world today, Filipino nurses are among the most sought after around the world because of your skill, dynamism, professionalism, perseverance, and above all, compassion. I hope you realize that the world is a better place because of you. Yes. And as my great ensure the professional mobility of our nurses is properly managed. Collectively, we must advance and protect the holistic welfare of Filipino nurses wherever they are in the world. We commend the BNAA and the PNA, the most active bodies advocating the promotion of rights and interests of our Filipino nurses. I would like to think that today's summit is a manifestation of both government and the NGO sector and can and work together to advance the cause of our countrymen, especially nurses overseas. With partnerships such as this, we are able to be more effective in moving towards the goal of a more competitive transnational Filipino community with continuing strong ties and linkages with the home country. Next slide. We are also well aware of the various philanthropic activities that our 10 million strong Filipinos diaspora are involved with. In CFO, we have Lingkod sa Kapwa Filipino or the Link Appeal that has helped bring in billions of pesos worth of cash and material assistance since the inception in 1990s. One of the components of the Link Appeal to the technology is the technology and skills transfer or Balik Turo, which taps the expertise of overseas-based Filipino professionals. Next slide. The Balik Turo project encourages Filipinos overseas with specific skills and expertise in science and technology, education, agriculture, environment protection, and it seeks to promote technology, and it seeks also to give opportunity to learn and adapt new technology from abroad to enhance existing services in the country. We are proud that in the previous years, the Filipino Nurses Associations and its members around the world have selfishly committed their time and generously shared expertise to the nurses in the Philippines. The beneficiaries are always grateful for these trainings as they also strive to make a difference in their patients' lives while at the same time advancing their skills in the nursing profession. We hope that the PNAA would renew its partnership with the CFO's Link Appeal program and continue the Balik Turo project with the CFO. Last slide. Likewise, as caretakers of the planet and as fitting tribute to our theme of climate change, developing resilience in communities, we would like to enjoin PNAA and everybody here present to do our part and help our kababayan who are displaced from their homes and currently in various evacuation centers in light of the eruption of the Taal volcano. The eruption of the Taal volcano is a testament that we are almost insignificant when Mother Nature takes over, but we can always help those affected by the wrath of Mother Nature. The CFO is calling for financial and material donations to provide services and emergency items to people in temporary shelters. You may send your donations to the CFO's trust account, which you can see on the screen. We thank you in advance for any help that you can extend to our kababayan, and rest assured we will be responsible and accountable with your donations. In conclusion, being a nurse is said to be one of the most selfless acts a person can undertake. In a world of varying cultures, customs, and beliefs of both joys and struggles, your